Hey everyone, I'm here again to have a wonderful conversation with people doing wonderful work all around the world. Today I'll be talking with Samith, who has been doing a lot of wonderful work in Cambodia. And he is a wonderful human being who has a great heart. My first question to Samith is, what has your mission effort been? What do you do in Cambodia and elsewhere, if you do work elsewhere?
So the purpose is just fundamental, because I believe God, I know Jesus, and usually rarely for the Cambodian people to know about this. So that's what when I found Jesus, I want a Cambodian, the one that I have contact, to know that, to believe. So that's what all of things start with. Purpose. And so it started more than 20 years ago. So whatever I learned, whatever I know Jesus, I want to share the life part of my life, and all the work that God doing in me, so to the Cambodian people. So it just not just among the church or among the people in Cambodian people in San Jose, but different state that I have contact, and also Cambodian around the world, because Cambodian is spread to many countries, like the Israel, like people. So yeah, we have in Canada and France and Australia, beside Cambodian in Cambodia.
Beautiful. So you mentioned that you are continuing your efforts stateside, locally. What goals are you trying to achieve with your work with the Cambodian people?
Yes, first to reach the unbeliever in the place locally and overseas, and also more than that, because our work involved in founding the church in Cambodia. Right now I work directly involved with leader over there, more than 30 to 40 church, but the church that we directly found and building and all of that, we have two main church over there. I work directly with pastor over there, and we send a lot of flyers, aid to the leadership over there every month or through all the year, and been on the trip to over there, teach the leader of leadership.
Wonderful. So why did you start your mission for God? Why did you start doing your work for his kingdom?
Okay. The first thing is, I believe the main thing is three things. Because when I found Jesus, I want everybody to find like me, because that is the only hope in the whole thing, you know. And if you find heaven, and you want everybody to find too, right? So that's what my main purpose when I found Jesus. And another thing is when I found that, and God prepared me for that. And when I look back to all my education and everything, my past, and before I wondered that I have a different purpose in my life, but up to now, right now, I know that Jesus prepared me, not for that thing, but for this thing. So that's what I'm going to use this thing, that whatever God bless me in, to bring him to the people. And also God, along the way, God always opened the door for me. And when I see the door open, I cannot resist the Lord. So that's what I keep doing, even sometimes in involved faith, trust, but I still have a lot of things. It's the first I thought is my a lot of burden, but after a while I know that I'm just his servant. He's the one that doing and make everything happen, and everything for him, not for me. So that's what I start do that. And even 20 years ago, up to now, when I start, I don't know where to go, but God wanted it.
That's beautiful. What challenges do you consistently face with your mission?
Yes, that's the thing is that I've been through all faith and failure, a lot of them, and doubt, trust. A lot of them, that's what struggle me all the time when you do the mission. Sometimes you see the obstacle and failure, and you just want to ask God where you want me to go. And travel, I do travel like almost every year to Cambodia. And so, yes, it's a lot of load to my family. So that's what it's sometimes struggle, but sometimes you have to look at the main thing. You just servant of God. God open for you. You do it.
Yeah, that's beautiful. And you mentioned you've been consistently traveling to Cambodia. How has the virus affected those living in Cambodia? And how has the virus affected your ability to continue your efforts?
Yeah, it's like I think that the COVID-19 pandemic start. I cannot go there anymore. And just me. And then yeah, a lot of people are like over there. They right now in Cambodia is a lot of COVID, spread all over the place. And even right now, the government closed the church. Just like over here a couple months ago, the whole year. So now the summer church do start to do it online, and
Wow.
they just bring people, 4 or 5 people, doing the church and put in the place. Just like I did it for more than a year online over here. So yeah, set up fight, and a lot of people got problem because they don't have work because they've been shut down even yes, and they cannot have to support themselves. Family-wise, so yes, it affects. It's more than us over here. Even we still have work, or still have job and all of that over there. Are gonna do all the farming thing, doing small because they just go to work day by day. If you don't have work, it's hard.
You mentioned it's very widespread. Do you know how what happens over there if they catch it? Is there a good medical system in place?
It is nothing, and it's hard. It's hard, and it's politically it's bad. And when people got the COVID, if you go to the hospital, it's when the person die, they just tell the family, yes, he died, but they burn the cremate for you, and they take everything that belong to them. People got that. iPhone or something with them, all the purse and everything, they don't give back to the family. They just say that I cremate and burn everything with that corpse. So that's what, yes.
That's terrible. That's
Terrible.
very traumatic.
Oh, yeah. That's what the people, a lot of time, people don't want to go to hospital. And a lot of time, they have no patient how to treat. So if it happens, on your own, it's in God's hand.
Wow.
Yeah.
And what about, you mentioned a lot of people aren't working. Have a lot of people been losing their businesses? Has the government been very strict?
Yes, the government, it's, you know that government, it's not good over there. And so it's nothing from the government, and it's more pressure from the government to do things for their politic purpose. So it's not good. It's very bad.
Wow. Have things been getting better in Cambodia like they have been here?
Right now, because over there the COVID, the pandemic start late in Cambodia. It just start like a couple months ago. Not last year. Last year, nothing. So it just started a couple months ago. Now it's in. It's still more. It's just like us last year.
Wow. Is there so I guess this next one is a two-part question. Is there anything people in the United States can do to help Cambodians? And then is there anything we can do to support your efforts?
Yeah, right now the first thing is prayer, because that bad thing that God, we need God through all of this, and then everything secondary. It's like we need encouragement, we need that prayer for encouragement and protection and all of that. Maybe it's a aid that we can help to the people over there.
Can anybody email you to see if they can help with anything specifically?
Yes, yes, I'm open. It's for the part of the mission. Yeah.
Wonderful. We'll include your email in the description in the video below. Anything else you'd like to add before we conclude?
Well, it's a. Now is the thing is a mission is part of my life, because God put in there. I cannot get away from it. So it's just prayer for that, and because if I look into the future, for me it's just like been many years. So sometimes you don't see where the direction to go to, but God the one that continue to reveal to me in step by step. So I don't know what the next step. That's gonna need more prayer.
For sure, we'll definitely keep praying for you. And
Appreciate it.
I had no idea that things were so bad in Cambodia. Just to share personally, I'm hearing more and more about a lot of countries not as infrastructurally sound as the United States that are getting it really bad now that got it later. Yeah, the best we can do is, well, we can definitely pray always, but definitely continue to educate people all around the world about what is actually going on. And yeah, that's a hard pill to swallow for a lot of people. But it's one that exists, and it's one that everybody has to do something. Yeah. Well, Pastor Smith, thank you so much for taking the time to discuss with me. For our audience, again, your email will be in the description below, so people will be able to contact you to find out how they can support your efforts. We will be continuing reaching out to people like Smith, who are wonderful people who are working consistently to help people all around the world. And thank you again, and we will catch you guys on the next one.
Hey, thank you very much.